Yeah, I kept having to throw that iPad down, and every time I threw it down, it was even worse. But then iPads are durable, I can tell you that.
This scene was brought to you by
iPad. Brought to you by iPad.
Welcome to Couch Surfing, the show where hunky guests look back at their big roles, their little roles, and everything in between. I'm here social distancing with Morris Chestnut. Morris, hi.
Hey, how are you?
How are you? How's it going?
I'm doing well.
Yeah, are you ready to surf?
Let's surf.
Let's do it.
Hey, you a punk, man.
Hey, yo, wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Look at baby Morris getting roughed up by Ice Cube.
See, that was my first fight scene on camera, like ever, like in a major production. And the whole thing is just, you know, and it was really like my first job. So I'm thinking, okay, I got to make sure he's going to take a swing. And they say, don't move your head too fast. And he's not going to come close. And look at this John Singleton right there. That was funny.
That's right.
And so they said, don't move your head too fast. You have to time it. And so it was a lot to think about, you know, for my first fight scene.
And this film made stars of a number of actors. And you've all gone on to have remarkable careers. Everyone from you and Angela Bassett to Regina King. What was it like when the cameras weren't rolling?
At the time, I was just trying to learn. I was just, you know, watching and learning. Every time Cuba would come out, because Cuba had a lot more experience than I did back then. And every time he would come out of his trailer, I'd ask him questions. But I think it's just a testament to John and how many, you know, he had a vision. Yeah. He saw all of us. He put us together in this just magical film, and just the story that he crafted, you know, shout to the late, great John Singleton, because it's all a testament to him and what he's done.
All right, let's keep surfing.
Let's surf.
You know, you don't meet a lot of women who can dribble.
Hey, you don't meet a lot of people who can dribble like that.
Fans love this episode. I love this episode. I mean, clearly all the girls, Regine, Khadija, all of them were fighting over you. Did you enjoy having all of that attention?
You know what? I'm not an attention guy. You know, I'm always just kind of, I'm a little low key, but that was a fun show to do. I actually wished at that time I could have been on the show, you know, as a regular.
I wanted you in more episodes, and I'm sure I wasn't the only one.
Thank you. I would have loved to have been in a few episodes, but it was my first time working with Queen Latifah, Kim, all, and everybody was just so great. I do remember that, and I had a lot of fun with that.
All right, up next.
All right, let's go.
I was down there. I ripped my pocket. Everything. Only thing I got in my pocket, man, is your ass.
Yes.
That was my first time working with Seagal. And it was just, you know, I was a part of a big, you know, action movie, and it was fun.
And you got to deliver. And you got to deliver lines like, the only thing I have in my pocket is your ass. Yeah.
I think they were looking for like a comedian at that point in time. And I came in and I knew they were looking for a comedian. And I was like, hey, you know, they're looking for a comedian. I don't care. I'm just going to do what I want to do. So I ad-libbed a lot of my lines. Scenes like that, you know, there were scenes where it was just me and another guy. Sometimes when I was in a scene with Seagal, he was writing all the lines, but I ad-libbed some of my lines. So I just had fun. So the director just let me have fun with it.
And Seagal clearly liked working with you because he brought you back again and you guys worked together a few times. What did you, what advice, if any, did he give you about the industry, and how did you find working with him?
You know, he didn't really give me that much advice. I mean, we didn't really talk like that. We just worked together.
Oh. Enough said or not said. Welcome back to Couch Surfing. I'm still here with Morris Chestnut. Morris, shall we continue?
Let's do it.
Yay!
Think about that business. Ooh, I always like the pleasure.
Oh, right. That was my second time working with Gabrielle Union, who's just incredible. She's just smart, witty, funny, fun. And then also, in my opinion, the incomparable Anthony Anderson.
Yes.
Anthony Anderson, and I. that just brings so many memories back. Anthony he's a great talent, and even back then, there was nothing that he wouldn't say or wouldn't do. So he always kept me on my toes.
You know, films like Brothers and Brown Sugar and this one really helped shape the way that Black people were depicted on screen. It's like Hollywood woke up and realized that there were actually Black yuppies, Black working professionals, and not everyone was a gang member in South Central. I mean, did you understand the significance of films like this at that time, and that they would help shape the way that Hollywood interacted with the Black viewer?
Without a doubt, it was something that I definitely wanted to be a part of. When I first started auditioning, it was always, you know, gang member number one, gang member number two, and I never really got those roles. And then I was fortunate to get Boyz in the Hood, but I didn't play a gang member. But it was a quote unquote gang film, some people thought. There was definitely a desire to see progressive Black people doing well, making money, in storylines that were relatable. And so I was fortunate to be there at the time to where, you know, The Best Man, Two Can Play That Game, The Brothers, all those films came up.
Fantastic. All right. Up next, this is fun.
Okay, here we go. I like this. Okay, here we go.
All right. Good luck to you, all right? Here we go.
Like Mike with a little Bow Wow. Like Mike. Like Mike. Little Bow Wow. I think he's just Bow Wow right now. And he can really, you know, he can really dribble. He can really play at the time. So I really thought when I got this part, I was going to raise my basketball game outside of this, because I like to play basketball on a regular basis. So I really thought when I was training, because I was training with Reggie Theus, who was an ex-NBA player, that I was going to raise my game. But it didn't work. It didn't work. Yeah, my game was still the same. But I had a great time, you know, working on that movie. There's Bow, there's Eugene Levy. You know, I had a fun time on this movie.
Up next.
Okay, let's see what
this
we got
is what
here.
It looks like I invited you.
Those scenes with Tay, even from the first one. I'm not sure if you ever interviewed Tay or if you ever met Tay. You probably have.
Tay has been on this show.
He's been on the show.
Yes.
Great dude. Yes. Great personality.
Yes.
Funny, humorous, witty. And it was always hard for me to go there with him. You know, it's always hard for me to go there with Tay because, you know, as soon as we say cut, I mean, he's just such a great dude, so witty and smart. And so so those scenes are challenging because, you know, because he's Tay.
He's Tay. Well, we had Tay on the show, as I mentioned, and he said that a new Best Man installment was in the works.
Yes.
Possibly a miniseries, possibly a movie. What can you tell me?
I can tell you that we all were on a Zoom call, not this weekend, but last week, we were all on a Zoom call to discuss how we're going to be moving forward. And right now, things are moving forward. So there is going to be something on the show. There's going to be a continuation coming soon.
But will it be a mini series?
It's looking like it's going to be a mini series because you know, it's one of the things that we wanted to. So in the movies, we can only touch on so much, and there's so many, you know, so many stories and character things that Malcolm wants to explore.
Right.
So it'd be a mini series.
Up next.
We're in the midst of the single most devastating public health crisis of our lifetime.
I love Barrett playing this character. It's kind of like being able to play the villain. It's something that people don't really expect from me.
Right. Because you always play the nice guy.
Yeah, I always play the nice guy. And it's also a show to where I really know that people are watching the show, because I'll be out sometimes. I'll be out, you know, getting gas or whatever, and people go, hey, man, I love you in all your movies. So Tyrese, when's your next one coming out? And I'll be like, that wasn't me in the Fast and the Furious. I'm sorry. That wasn't me. But, you know, so when people come up to me about this show,
right,
I know that they're really watching, because they come up to me and, ooh, I can't understand your character and why did you lie to those people? Yeah, they admonished me.
Now, before I let you go, I know you have a few more exciting projects coming out. Yes. Tell me more about them and where can fans check them out?
Got The Best Man coming out. We're going to be talking about that. And there's another remake that I can't really say anything just yet.
Come on.
I can't say anything
Just whisper.
I can say that possibly there's going to be another installment to maybe, possibly, one of the clips that you've shown on here. Yeah, I can say that. And it's not The Best Man. That's the only clue that I can give yet, because nothing has happened yet. We're just in conversations.
But it's not Under Siege 3, right?
No, it's not Under Siege 3.
Thank you so much. You have been absolutely wonderful. Thank you
so much. Thank you.
The Resident airs Tuesdays on Fox. Check it out. See you next time on Couchsurfing. Bye.
Okay.